I'm back with another theropod, Nanoxaurus. It's a small tyrannosaur that lived in the Arctic alongside Pachyrhinosaurus during the Late Cretaceous. I decided to sculpt two of them, snuggling together to fight the cold. As always, I create a skeleton with wire and sculpt the rough shape of Self-Sculpey. Then I went on to sculpt the heads. Although there is some debate about Nanoxaurus's size, it is certain that it was much smaller than its famous cousin Tyrannosaurus rex. This is probably due to the environment it lived in. Because of the extremely cold weather, resources were scarce, and an animal as big as Tyrannosaurus rex would not have found enough food to survive. Nanoxaurus's more modest size allowed it to thrive in a very unwelcoming environment. I covered most of their head and body with small, fur-like feathers to help them keep warm. I sculpted them both laying down. Fossilized prints have shown that theropods, indeed, laid down on the ground. I don't know of any fossil of a sleeping tyrannosaur itself, but a tiny theropod, named Meilong, was found still curled in a sleeping position. I tried to reproduce that for one of my dinosaurs. And for the other one, I took inspiration from a sleeping ostrich with the head resting on the neck. They're even chubbier than my usual sculptures because I wanted to give them a puffed up look in the same fashion as a sleeping bird. Meilong's tail was wrapped around its body, but I wasn't sure Nanoxaurus's tail was flexible enough to do that, since it was a fairly big dinosaur. I didn't want to take the risk, and I sculpted the two tails pretty straight, as can be seen in this Chiang Mai Anaya. Although it's an ornithopod and not a theropod, I assumed that their tails might sit in the same way, since they're both bipedal. I always pre-bake the claws before sculpting the toes. This way, it's easier for me to keep them quite sharp and straight. I add some details to the feet. And then some folds and wrinkles to make the sculpture more realistic. I took the liberty not to cover the feet with feathers and left them scaly, because most birds I know don't have feathers on their feet. Lastly, I sculpt two pairs of tiny arms half buried in the feathers. the last patch of feathers. And I'm done. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.